We need to start by understanding the process of building a neural network. It's essentially four steps. The first one is all about data acquisitions. Here we need data both in quantity and quality. This data needs to be relevant and must convey the information that we need. Now, the second thing to do is how we use this data. For that, we use all our acquired knowledge, our background, to come up with a strategy. What are the best tests that we can run so that we can get the most information on how to identify the failure? Much like a doctor, if he sees you walking a little bit winky, will ask you for an x-ray. It's important to mention that we don't just rely on one single test. No, no. We had a lot of redundancy. This means that our models are competing for the same event against each other to make sure that what they are doing is reliable. So the next step is to present this diagnosis at the right time and in a way that the user can interpret it while staying true to what's really happening. Keep in mind that our system will take into consideration your maintenance team situation. We actually feed continuously from their feedback. Regardless of their maturity level, we ensure that we'll provide the highest level of maintenance reliability. If we add up all our strategies, our models, and everything that we've built so far, all of this, it translates into results. Plus, it's USPTO patented, so you can be sure that there is no other like it on the market. Now that you know the inner workings of what we do, this is the part that really shines: auto diagnosis. If you have a ball bearing failure, for example, Tractian AI will identify the vibration peaks at the bearing failure frequencies, which at the time will generate a prescriptive diagnosis with procedure suggestions. Each insight that's displayed on the platform shows the identified fault, its severity with a behavior chart, and suggestions for routes of actions that you should take to prevent full breakdown. If you wonder how we can achieve such high levels of accuracy and precision, the secret behind this is that we actually run all our process in three levels. The first layer is the relation to the machine itself, where the data from the latest sample is compared with the equipment history, identifying how faults have developed over time. The second layer involves comparing the machine with similar assets from the same plant. This makes it easier to identify specific anomalies or type of operational conditions that might affect production on a somewhat broader scale. So the third layer, this is where we take our approach to the next level. We take the asset, and in this case, we will compare it to thousands of machines, all similar to the one we're targeting, in order to understand if the anomalies or the behavior we're seeing can be explained under different world circumstances and conditions. All this provides valuable insights into best practice, market trends, and opportunities for improvement. It's a true benchmarking tool for companies that want to be pioneers in their fields.